What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Blues TV. Chelsea have just beaten Newcastle 1-0 at Stamford Bridge. It's 5 wins in a row. I'm here with Ben Roberts. Ben, what are your thoughts today?
Standard. You know, at least we know how to beat Newcastle. United couldn't. Spurs couldn't. Yeah, I said Spurs. But look, it's another win. 5 on the trot now. Like I said in your vlog, we're now going undefeated till Anfield. We're going to win the league at Anfield, mate.
What's that, 32 games unbeaten or something like that?
Who cares? I don't know. But we're going to win the league, mate. I'm not happy with it. I know that Man City will come back and win it, probably. But the game was stressful. It was very, very stressful. Lots of chances missed in the second half. It could have been 4, could have been 5. But credit to the keeper, credit to Newcastle defence. They stopped the shots when they needed to. But
how do you think about the first half? Because I thought first half we came into the game very slowly.
We seemed switched off first half. You know, we let Newcastle, especially St Maximin, run down that wing. We gave them too much respect, and they almost punished us for it. But they didn't make too much shots. I don't think I even saw Kepa do much. I think he could have just sat in his chair, brushed his teeth, comb his hair, and he still wouldn't have to do anything. Again, the priority here is that we've got 3 points. We're now third with, obviously, Arsenal and Man City yet to play. But, you know, if I'd been in a situation about a month ago, I'd be probably laughing, because the transformation you can tell is happening. You know, I said the attack's good, we just need to work on the defence. Another clean sheet, which is absolutely perfect, especially as, you know, Zuma was a little bit shaky. Tomori's second half near the end was a bit shaky. But, you know, the 3 points is a massive hit.
What do you think about Marcus Alonso's form? Obviously, he was the only goal scorer today. Unlucky Newcastle fans. But how do you think about his form today and in recent games as well? Because he's now started to be reintegrated back into the first team.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to say it's regen Marcus Alonso from Conte days, but this ain't last season's Alonso, at least.
Marcus Alonso last season pissed me off. He just looked like he couldn't give a fuck, but, you know, he I think it was a case of, you know, he had the guaranteed left back spot. He was playing and playing and playing, and, you know, it was on threat. But now that Emerson's stepped up, he's thinking, shit, I've got to fight for my place. You know, it's not a guarantee I'm going to start a left back. I need to put in the performances again. So, and obviously getting the winner, obviously a massive rub in the wounds for Newcastle. We'll see a former Sunderland player score a goal like that late on as well, and it being the only goal in the game. Like I say, I think Tammy should have scored, I think Pulisic should have scored. I think if you put it a little bit to the left of the keeper, it's going in. If Abraham was very unlucky, you know, it was very good defending, you know, basically goal line clearance. Newcastle probably saved themselves a lot of goal difference today from the second half alone. But, you know, we've got to look onwards and upwards now. Every single player was fantastic. Willian has stepped up massively in such short time. You know, I was ready to say, get him out the club, get him out the door. You know, why didn't we take the 50 million from Barcelona? Robson Odoi, brilliant as always, you know, cutting in, using skills, beating defenders. I'm very, very happy that he signed that new contract. You know, there's no more worry with that. Tammy Abraham, mate, 21-year-old player.
Tammy Abraham had a very frustrating game today. I'm not saying he played badly, because he really didn't. He had plenty of chances. It's just, you know, when you're a striker and you have one of them games and the ball's going everywhere except in the net. That was one of his games today.
He done his job. He done what he needed to do. You know, he got into the positions. He was very unlucky not to score. You know, Newcastle done well, you know, containing him. But you got to look at it like this. He's 21 years old. He's one of the top scorers in the Premier League.
He's already overachieving.
Yeah. You know, I mean, everyone's hating on him, you know, saying that he's a shit Rashford. He's 2 goals off Rashford's best ever season.
You say shit Rashford, at least mate, nowadays.
I've seen people say it. It's fucking cringy, mate. Yeah. You know, Tammy Abraham is going to grow up. When he matures into that starting player role, he's going to be one of the most dangerous strikers in the Premier League. He's going to make Harry Kane look like a poor man's Villabocci.
Big statement.
I am Sophie Rose.
And I'm Lewis Gebre-Selassie, and we are your new presenters for Blues TV for the upcoming season.
So make sure you click the subscribe button and keep